What's good, guys? If you want cheap, fast, and reliable NBA 2K20 My Team coins, head on over to NBASafe.com and use code BUGS for 5% off at checkout.
If you're looking to buy a stacked NBA 2K account with max badges and more, visit SportsTMB.com. He has been in the community for years and has hundreds of reviews. Click the first link in the description to get your account today.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Bugs back with another NBA 2K20 My Team video. And guys, today we got our fourth video of the day because you guys are goated. The support has been crazy. We're about to hit 60k real-time views, bro. Numbers like that happen with people with like 30k plus subs, and I can't thank you guys enough for the support. Before we get into it, guys, if you could smash that sub button and that like button, that would be greatly appreciated. We got some MT making methods, market talk, all that good stuff. We're getting closer and closer to Scottie Pippen as well. Guys, the support, I can't even talk about it. Like, it's crazy. I'm literally just looking at my views go up and up and up. My likes, my subs. Thank you, guys. If you're a new sub, let me know in the comments what's going on. Wow, I can't. And also, bro, we're about to hit 1,000 followers on Twitter, guys. If you don't follow my Twitter, make sure to follow it. We also buy and sell MT on there and do MT giveaways. We're close to 10k. Make sure to smash that sub button. You will not regret it. But anyways, let's get into this video. So, I actually was looking through my collection, and I was actually looking at some stuff, and some things actually crossed my eyes, and I was like, what? So if you guys have any of these players, at least some of these players, like this Udonis Haslam is so rare, and people are going to need to complete it to get Anthony Davis. So if you guys want to go ahead and actually try to look through all these old collections, they actually go for MT. So first off, if you want to make a lot of MT and you played the game since day one, you might have some of these bums in your collection. I just wanted to throw this out because I was actually looking at it last night. And these cards are literally so expensive and they're trash. So like, if you want to make MT, literally just go in your collection, look at old collections, and simply just throw these cards in the auction block. Like, straight up, I'm shocked. I can't believe these cards are so expensive. Sapphire Shaq's going for a decent amount as well. And not only that, if you want to sit on this filter, I mean, it's probably not active at all, but if you get a Udonis Haslam for like 5k or whatever, you could possibly flip him for like 40,000 MT. I had that Udonis Haslam too, which is such an L because I actually got rid of him for the low as well. So yeah, bro, Udonis Haslam, personally, I would definitely recommend checking that out. That is something you definitely want to pay attention to. We got these new legacies, these old legacies, I should say. Some of these cards are going for some decent amount of MT, even though they are in the token reward, bro. If you guys do remember, this Austin Carr, we got him for free, I think, somehow. But like, dude, a lot of these cards are literally straight garbage, and you can make a lot of MT off them just by selling them in your collection. A lot of you guys might have them in your collection. Yeah, so like, pretty much, if you just look through your collection, you could make a lot of MT, and you don't even realize it. Like, some of these Sapphires, a little MT here, a little MT there. If you're not going for collector level, you could sell some of these old cards, like hidden gems, like an Emerald for 4K. If you have this card, 4K, go make that MT, bro. Straight up, go make that MT. Also, I was looking at something, man. If you have Pink Diamond Giannis. If you have Pink Diamond Giannis, he is so expensive. And also, for all the guys that did invest in the new bowl, congratulations. But, oh my goodness, I'm in shock. This Pink Diamond Giannis is so damn rare. Obviously one of the best point guards in the game, but wow. If you want to throw him up and make a lot of MT, I have a feeling Giannis is coming soon, bro. 2K loves Giannis. I love Giannis. He's the MVP. They always pay attention to MVPs. We're talking about MVP Giannis. This Giannis, when they drop an Opal Giannis, it's a wrap. Like, if they literally drop Opal Giannis, it's over. The market is going to crash so hard. So, like, honestly, if you have Pink Diamond Giannis, I would recommend selling. I'm really considering selling mine, even though I don't want to because he's literally the GOAT. But, yeah. I want to talk about a couple things. First off, if you're not selling your cards, you have to sell your cards because, dude, the market's literally so high. And the new bowl, oh my goodness, if you invested in the new bowl, you are so valid. I know one sub that invested at 40K, a couple of the new bowls, he's at 70K. Now, if you took my method and I literally said invest in these super pack cards, the pink diamonds or whatever, dude, I can't believe this card's 70K. He might go up to 80K. First off, he's 7'7", and I green all his shots. I'm starting him. He's one of my start, not my start. He's on my bench. But, dude, it's the fact that he's so OP. He's 7'7", and kids are going to want him on his team. This card is the stopper of every single center in the game. He's 7'7", lanky, has glitchy animations. This card's going to continue to go up. If you want to invest in him 7K, it's not a good idea because it's risky. But if you could somehow snipe some for 40K or less or did invest into him, it's a good time to sell now. Unless you want to wait a little longer, it's always risky. But then again, he's out of packs for a really long time. So that's kind of interesting also. So we got that. Market's really high, like I said. We got the new Kuzma. Not a fan. Trash card in my opinion. Clyde's down. Also, a lot of people were saying I had Luka. Do I sell him? My opinion, I do not want to sell the Luka. Honestly, I'm probably going to pick him up again for around 2-something on Friday when the market does crash. Because, bro, prime packs are something you want to pay attention to. If you guys do know, think about Luka Doncic. Hype beast. Everybody loves Luka. I love Luka. He's a beast. He's good in real life. Now, if you think about it, this card is really good. What makes me think is, since this card is actually really good, you kind of want to hold on to it. Also, because, first off, he's going to go up in value. Not like prime super packs are going to come up for a while. So I believe his price goes up to 350, maybe even 400. This guy is honestly one of the best shooting guards in the game. And you could really, really, really make a lot of MT if you hold on to them. First off, you're holding on to a Galaxy Opal. That's OP. So you're fine with that. Also, bro, Melo and Magic went up a ton. So honestly, market's rising. Market continues to rise. If you have some secret snipe filters or whatever that you want to share with me, I could tell to the community, let me know. Right now, the methods are pretty much just paying attention to pricing. Literally, you have to pay attention to pricing. Also, all you guys that did invest in diamond contracts, you have dubbed out. I dubbed out myself. I'll show you how many I got. I got so many diamond contracts, and honestly, I'm going to dub out. I also put a ton on my players. Got all these cards for around 9K, 10K. So yeah, bro, like literally it's crazy how good these diamond contracts actually did to end up turning out. If you guys invested, like I said, bro, they're up a lot. I don't know. They're still going up for snipes. Not as frequently. I actually been checking that out lately, but they're almost up to 12K. Now I got all mine for around 9,500 and under. These cards are almost up to 12K. So if you do the math, if you got them for 9K times 10 is 90,000 MT. You sell them for 12, you make 11 clean. You're going to make about 20 to 30K MT that easy. Now, if you invested about 400,000 MT, it adds up. That's why investments are key. If you don't listen to investments, you're not going to make that much MT. First off, like I said, bro, snipe filter is obviously a good idea. But investments, in my opinion, are the safer, faster route. Also, if you invested in Zeller, that also did pan out. If you guys have Trae Young and you have Caruso, can you please stop throwing them up for buyouts? Like, literally stop. Like, I'm so sick of these cards being buyout. They're Opals. Don't let 2K dub. Like, let us get snipes, dude, straight up. But yeah, like I was saying, honestly, overall, all I'm going to say is, if you're playing single player triple threat TTO, I mean, it's a pretty good way to make MT right now, not going to lie. Just not really a fan. I don't really like single budget with that TTO because, bro, getting Nick Van Arsdale is like lowest chance, bro. I played 2 games so far today. I got 10 tokens of the vault, but yeah, the vault's been lagging too, so I kind of stayed away from it. To make a lot of MT and some tokens, you can also wait till about 10 o'clock at night and get some extra tokens. That would be pretty deadly. I'm thinking about running a stream tonight. If I do, and you don't follow me on Twitter, I'll probably end up doing that as well. But yo, right now, if you want to make MT, it's simple. You listen to my method by selling now and getting ready for snipes on Friday. Is there going to be a market crash Friday? Probably not. I think it's just going to be a basic prime day where they drop opals that don't really crash the market because they're not like hyped. They're going to be good cards for real, but for some reason, the primes never really crash the market. They just like play with the market. They just like tease the market and make it a little weird. But like seriously right now, especially if you have Blake Griffin, I would recommend selling him because honestly, he is kind of expensive and I think he might drop to 2-something like Porzingis as well because he's not really in a set. He's not going to hold that much value even though he is really, really good. I just really feel like he's going to end up going down in price like a lot. So he's actually 355K. So if you do have Blake, I would recommend selling. You probably pick him up for like 2-something over the weekend or something like that. But yeah, honestly, guys, that's really all I got for the video. I hope you guys enjoyed. These MT methods, bro, like, straight up, they're so deadly. If you guys are in, like, if you really pay attention to some of these sets, they're so old. No one really has these cards. So, like, if you want to make some MT, would definitely recommend looking at some of these old sets. Make a lot of MT this way, and also sniping out some little stuff. Little stuff adds to big stuff, bro. So, yeah, hope you guys enjoyed the video. Stay tuned for more content. Hope you guys did. Oh, wait a second. If you invested in Manute Bol at 20K, oh, my God, you're a millionaire. Both Manute Bols. Oh, wow, I messed up. So, if you guys do remember, they dropped the Super Packs. He was at 20, 25K. He's now at 45. Wow, I'm shocked. So, yeah, that's all I got for the video. Hope you guys enjoyed. Stay tuned for more content. Have a good one. I'm shocked. Peace.